I draw the blind, I think in my mind, what will I see? Flowers, birds, a swaying tree. Something caught my gaze. It's always been here, all my days. The tree outside stands there with pride, with a perfect pure white glow. It's lovely to have it there on show. The delicate star-shaped flowers, I could stare at them for hours. It makes me think without a blink. Nature's beauty has a duty.
I woke up and decided to focus on what's outside my bedroom window. Our crabapple tree is stunning this year. It has finally recovered from a bout of mealybug infestation after 2 years. It and I never gave up. So I was well pleased. The dawn chorus was lovely. The robin was singing, so was the wren. Then far off, I hear the cacophony of the rookery. The wail of the peacock resounds across the field, and sheep bleat constantly for their lambs. All such calming sounds. The blackbird appeared as usual, cocky little thing. The crow is perched in its usual place, on top of our neighbor's roof. The seagulls, the pigeons, and every bird around us crying out for attention. Whilst in the skies, a dark cloud loomed. Then a surprising glimpse of a rainbow completed my morning rise.
have significantly reduced the velocity of the sun visiting the sea, so we need to keep a very close eye on that. Therefore, the threats are significantly reduced the velocity of the sun visiting the sea, so we need to keep a very close eye on that. Therefore, the threats are significantly reduced the velocity of the sun visiting the sea, so we need to keep a very close eye on that. Therefore, the threats are significantly reduced the velocity of the sun visiting the sea, so we need to keep a very close eye on that. Therefore,
that's a goldfinch. There it is. There. Two pickers and a sack. The first sighting of a brimstone stopped me in my track. Then a glove, more discussed trash, interspersed with cartoon paintings at the neighborhood crash. More plastic, and soon our bag became heavy. But we took our time and saw some fungi. A little later, litter here and there, we stopped to hear the goldfinch sing with nary a care. Crossing the road, we entered the cemetery where lives were lost yet remain in memory. Then once again, another bird song caused us to pause, listening to a black cat. What a delight that was. When we finally came to tie our bag, we walked home satisfied with the lovely walk we had.
It's a black cat. That's why it's singing so beautifully. It's a black cat.